quite slowly and clearly, because I noticed there's a number of Australians in the audience today. Well, we love you, really. We'll see what happens in the World Cup. So the geyser here was first discovered in the late 1800s by prisoners from New Zealand's first open prison farm, which is based at the, over here on my right. The prisoners were employed clearing the local land for forestry, and also with upkeep of local paths and roads. So as you can imagine, that was a fairly dirty job. So the prisoners would come down here and wash their clothes and themselves in the hot pools and hot streams around here. In those days, the geyser cone was a lot lower. That's of this sort of height. So it's like a small hot spring among the rocks. So the prisoners put in their clothes, added the soap, and much to their surprise, they sparked an eruption. Their clothes shot skywards. They all scrambled off into the bush here. When they finally got back here, they thought they'd have a bit more fun with the geyser and increased the pressure. So they added the basic rocks around here. And over the last 100 years, the silica that's in the water beneath us has coated those rocks and given us the distinctive silica cone shape. The geyser is named after Lady Constance Knox. She was the daughter of the then Governor of New Zealand, Lord Granville. He was down visiting the area in 1903, and Lady Knox came down here, christened the geyser, and soaked it herself. It's been soaked daily now since the early 1930s, so nearly the last 80 or so years, and it's still playing as strong now as it did then. The geyser normally plays for anything between sort of 30 minutes to about an hour, but the initial eruption is normally the highest and strongest. So hopefully today a good 10 to 15 metres, she then dies down but continues playing very tight for the next hour or so. We do tend to get a bit of a wind drift, which normally blows the geyser into this group of people over here. Don't panic, the water's quite cool by the time it gets to you with a slightly soapy feel. If you have any questions about the geyser or anything about Wai-Tapu Thermal Wonderland, please ask any of us things at Visitor Centre. We're very happy to answer all your questions. Please be careful as you drive back to the Visitor Centre. The road is quite narrow. And also when you're at the Visitor